Hi, I'm Laura Leuenberger. I'm one of the Chief Fellows at Ohio State's Pulmonary and Critical Care Fellowship.
Hey, I'm Kashi Goyle. I'm also one of the Chief Fellows. Laura and I are hoping to give you a little bit more information into our clinical training and what life is like in Columbus and ultimately why OSU was right for us.
When I was looking at fellowship programs, like everyone, I was hoping for a program with a strong clinical experience. And I think we definitely get that here. We have a big hospital. We have 72 medical ICU beds. We have two consult services, and we have a really big footprint throughout the hospital. And that sort of gives us the advantage of just having a lot of procedures and experiences to go around. So we don't worry everybody sort of who gets the experiences they want in terms of intubations and chest tubes and bronchs. There's no sort of concerns about having enough to go around. And that's true for interventional and sort of an advanced procedures too, if that's something you're interested in. But even despite kind of how big our inpatient experience is, I think we have a lot of general pulmonary both on the consult side and in the outpatient side. Our fellows clinic is kind of a whoever walks through the door. And so you really get that experience of everything from asthma to new IPF to kind of following IPF or sarcoidosis or all sorts of sort of different types of pathologies. But people get a lot of time to spend in subspecialty clinics if that's something they're interested in too. So some of our recent graduates have been able to kind of build careers right out of fellowship in things like transplant or pulmonary hypertension or sarcoid without kind of needing to do extra time because they built that training into their general pulmonary fellowship. And I think that comes out of our track system. So our tracks, we have sort of different tracks that people pick into their second year. And it's not meant to be prescriptive or kind of make you do anything, but to kind of make sure that you are spending time in your fellowship program to build the career and expertise that you need for kind of after fellowship when we're in that scary attending world. And so with those tracks, people who are interested in have time to sort of build basic science or clinical research experiences, or people who are interested in kind of specific clinical niches or to be a clinical expert in a certain field can build that into their career. And uniquely, I think here we have the experience to also have built a career as a medical educator, a medical administrator. And I think those tracks, like I said, kind of build you to be able to be in the career that you want. And that comes out of a culture of a program fellowship leadership that is really committed to kind of building you and what your interests are. And that's true of the division and the department as a whole, is that their goal is to educate you as a fellow to build you into be the physician that you want. And so I felt like in choosing OSU that I had the chance to be to get that excellent clinical experience while also being able to kind of build the career that I wanted.
For me, I have the unique perspective of being a returning Buckeye in the sense that I was here for medical school and then transitioned away for training, for residency, and decided to come back for fellowship. That decision was based on the excellent clinical training that Laura talked about, the opportunities for our tracks, but also accounting for Columbus as a city. So Columbus is, of course, a Midwestern city, but it has a diverse population, both in background and in thought process. The city is made up of small neighborhoods that have their own identity and personality that our trainees get to choose and take advantage of. We have a great food scene here too. Having been both in Boston and now in Columbus, I think Columbus might have them beat. And for me, I have some personal elements. I'm a parent and a member of a dual physician household. And OSU embraces and honors and strives to find a work-life balance. And we do that in many ways. We have a night float system, so that prevents any need for 24-hour call for our fellows. And I think that matters a lot. And that support comes from our faculty as well, in the access to mentoring and sponsorship that really is a thread through our program. We know you have a lot of decisions that are coming up, and we hope that you think of OSU in your interview and application process. See you soon.